Hi, I'm John Twist of University Motors. I want to say a little something today about our service, which we call a complete lubrication. That's not a very sexy name, and some people say, well, I don't need to spend $500 to have my oil changed. But a complete lubrication, as we define it, is from end to end, top to bottom, side to side. It's a lubrication, inspection, and adjustment. Here on this form, which you can't see the whole thing, this is our complete lube, we have many, many, many individual tasks on both sides of this piece of paper. And I just want to take a look at the car, which we have up on the hoist, and explain some of what a complete lubrication is. Not in the order that we do it, but from front to back. We put oil in the rack and pinion, and we make sure that the boots are okay. These boots were faulty. We just changed these rack and pinion boots. We grease the front wheel bearings, and remember that the MGB front wheel bearings are different from everybody else's wheel bearings in that the front nut should be at about 60 pounds of torque and not just finger tight until you take up the slop. So there's some shims and it's tricky to do it just right. We also put oil in the shock up here. We put shock oil and we grease the front suspension. We also push up and down on the cross member because now it's not uncommon to have the pads, which are up in here, the pads that hold the cross member to the body, it's not uncommon to have those fail. They have the whole cross member floating. So we talked about lubing the front end, filling the front shocks, taking care of the rack and pinion. Some of the work towards the back of the car is inspection. We drain the oil, refill that. We drain the oil out of the gearbox, refill that. Take a look at the mounts. Ooh, look at this guy, he's loose, okay? So our mount here is loose, and it's not uncommon to have the gearbox mounts up in here, absolutely gooey. This one I can press the screwdriver into it because it's had oil washed against it for years and years. In fact, if it wasn't for the fact that our cars leak oil and completely coat the undercarriage with grease and oil, our cars would have rusted and broken in half. So it's a good thing that our cars drip just a little bit of oil. We grease the drive shaft and make sure that the U-joints are parallel. These U-joints are parallel. Here's the fixed axis, that goes straight up and down. Here's the fixed axis, that goes straight up and down. It's got some different kind of zerks in it, but we take care of that. Towards the back end, we take apart the rear brakes. We'll come on outside and take a look at the brake drum from the back end. This one, the rear hub oil seal had failed. Everything inside of here was just covered with goo. I wish we had a picture of it. It would have been a really good shot. But it was all gooey, so we changed the shoes, put on a different drum. The wheel cylinder was just fine. We changed the hub oil seal. And as it turned out, the great big nut back here, the 1 5/16 nut up here on the axle, this is almost hand tight. So we rattled him tight and got the other one tight. We lubricate the handbrake cable. Now those of you who notice that this is a rubber bumper car know that this is not the correct handbrake cable for the car. This is an earlier cable, but the earlier cables are better than the later cables. So there's a grease zerk up here. So we had one person pushing grease into the grease zerk, another person sitting inside the car pulling up on the handle, and another person out here, in fact that was me this morning, pulling the handbrake cable off. And as we moved the cable back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, probably 50 times, finally we got some grease. See this grease here? That grease finally worked its way out of the cable, meaning that there's grease all the way along the cable, which is what it should be, so that it works correctly. We drain the differential, refill the differential, and do a lot of inspection on the exhaust mounts, and the bottom side of the car is only part of the attention the car gets. We work up on the top side too. We tighten up the screws that hold the door latches on. We tighten up the screws that hold the soft top on. grease up the seat slides, service the battery, sandblast the fuse box. Oh my gosh, two full pages, 5 or 6 hours of work. But this complete lubrication covers everything, everything. And from there on out, you can approach vehicle maintenance on a scheduled basis. But if you've just purchased a car, or you don't know the history of your car, or you've never had a complete lubrication, do it yourself. I'll send you the form, or bring it on up here and we'll do it. It's not inexpensive, but it is so very, very helpful. Other things, we bleed the rear brakes, we bleed the front brakes, we exercise the front brake calipers. Oh my gosh, we do so much stuff. Anyway, thanks very much. Next place, next time I'm gonna be someplace, will be in Altoona, Pennsylvania, at the Central Pennsylvania British Car Meet. That is the weekend following Memorial Day. We're starting to make plans for our summer party next summer. Stay tuned. We're going to feature the MGB, the pull handle MGB, and we're going to do this in conjunction with the VSCDA, the Vintage Sports Car Drivers Association. And they're also having a 50th anniversary. And I think they'll have about 100 race cars up at Grattan. And with luck, we'll have 300 cars here or so, maybe more. It'll be a really good party. And for those of you who've waited a long time for another party, here we go. We're going to have another one. Until then, see you later.